Next talk is in charge of Julie and Jesse Gilbert. And the topic of this, the next talk that we're gonna listen is connecting a point of sales with Odoo return on experience. Julian has 8 years of experience working in business analysis and also in project management. He has been working with Odoo for about 4 years now, and his main experience has been with conducting projects for different types of companies like distribution, manufacturing, service, and entertainment. And of course, he has a lot of experience working on customization. Please, Julian,
yes.
Let us with your talk.
Thanks, Rodrigo. Hello, everyone. So today I'd like to share with you with an experience that we had last year on a project for one of our clients. So the addendum will be the as following. We will present the main needs and the features of the solution. Then we will go into details to review the solution design. And then I will propose you a short demonstration of the solution. And at least I'd like us to share on the different experience you might have on this this matter. So the client we did the project for is in a multi-company context. He's operating in recreation centers and spa in Quebec. He has three companies. Two of them are running public are in public centers and spa, and it represents 21 service centers across Quebec. For these two companies, two different application of POS are used. And during the implementation of Odoo, the client didn't want to implement the POS under Odoo. Actually, the two application that he was using was very extensive in terms of features. And it was not necessary a good call to switch to get under Odoo the two application of POS. So the application he was in is still using is BEST. BEST is a local solution based in Canada, and Resort Suite, which is a solution designed for the hotel and spa. So I have set the link. If you are curious, you can just check on the solutions. So that is for the context. The scope of the project was extensive. Apart from the POS, we did integrate every operation and workflow of the client. So as going forward in the context, each center, so each spa and recreation center must have its own profit and loss statement, as it is run as a business unit. And the client must be able to know if the unit is profitable or not. Also, there were some specifics that was a challenge for us. For instance, some clients' bills when they visit the center were reported on the hotel, so that the hotel and my client had an agreement for the payment. As the timeline, we have had only 2 months to deliver the solution, which was very short given the given the different specifics that we just saw. So you'll see after after the presentation that we had to take some search shortcuts to be able to deliver the solution in the given deadline. As for the features and client goals, there were too many features covered, the accounting and the inventory. So it was mainly the same needs. It was to be able to automate the import of revenues and update the accounting on a recurring base. And also for the inventory, it was to automate the import of the stock moves and update the inventory. The global solution design, we did have the same approach for both of the features. We had to import the transactions as for the accounting and the inventory. We did decide to go with an intermediate tables to process the data. At this step here in intermediate tables, it's almost complete raw data. It's mostly text data. And so this import is made by the BioChrome, and then we convert the raw data into Odoo data, the target model. We will see more in details after what it's like in the application. So to the process, we use JobQueue to process the jobs. And of course, we use mapping tables to map the data from the external posts to the target model in Odoo. Going more specifically into the solution design, as for accounting, we use four different modules. Of course, in addition, there are account module to manage the accounting. But as for the connector, we use the SFTP. SFTP is a module that that manages the and bring the general method to import data from a given server to Odoo. So it doesn't bring and it doesn't add the specific method for our connector and our file format, but it gives the frame and the general method to import via SFTP. We have another module which is named post import. This module gives just an abstract model to import transactions into Odoo. So this module doesn't manage per se the importation of a transaction, but just gives an abstract model. Then we have the main module of the accounting features, which is post import account. This module, it adds the intermediate tables that we just saw to stock the transactions from the posts. It adds the mapping tables, and of course it manages the importation of the data from the posts and the conversions to the target models in Odoo. Target models here are the account move and account move line. As for the inventory, it's quite the same thing, but inventory side. So we have the SFTP, which has the same effect here. Post import again, to manage and bring an abstract model to import the transactions. And then we have post import stock, which does the same thing as post import account, but inventory side. So it adds also intermediate tables to stock the inventory transactions from the post. It adds the mapping tables and it's managed the conversion of the raw data to models, to Odoo models. So as you will see, as you can understand, we had only 2 months to design the solution, to specify it, to code and to test and deploy. So we had to take shortcuts to be able to manage the deadline. So as a result, the solution is not split enough. As for example, the solution depends on when warehouse analytics. Warehouse analytics is a module that allows to propagate, to define analytic account on a warehouse and to propagate the analytic account onto account moves. So ultimately, and ideally, the solution could be working without analytics, because I guess all clients may not need to manage the analytics at this stage. But to be able to deliver, we had to merge and limit the complexity of the solution. So that's it. For now, the solution, you won't find it on our GitHub. It's stored on a private repository because as it's not ideally designed and built, we didn't think it was relevant to propose it publicly. But we are open to change and to share source code if we can help into a project for a generic connector, for example. So now what it gives in the applications. So here we have deployed the solution on the enterprise version, but of course it works on the Odoo community. So we have several impact in the application. First, on the warehouse, what's important in the warehouse? The warehouse is considered as the center. So it's the spa center, and as it is the spa center, we need to manage parameters on the warehouse to be able to automate the account transactions and to create the payments. For example, we define the journal for post transaction so that we can define where the revenues goes as for this center. Also, we need to have a default partner to record and to convert the payment when the partner is not known from the data we receive from the post. That is the case where the client have the one-time client and doesn't want to track the client in detail, the partner in detail. So in this case, we just apply a default partner with its accounting parameters. Also, and this is managed by the module Warehouse Analytics, we define an analytic account on the warehouse. So we are able to propagate this analytic account onto account move lines for the revenues line. So this is for the warehouse side, and this allows us then to go and process the data from an accounting side. So in the accounting, we have had several menus. The menu are restricted to the manager of the accounting. And the menus are as follows. So you have three entries to manage and go to the list of the intermediate tables.
Julian?
Yes.
Sorry to interrupt. I don't know if you are intended to be sharing your screen, but most of us can see your screen.
Yes. Sorry. I see.
Sorry about that.
No, you're right. I'm sorry. I use a different laptop because I was afraid Zoom wasn't working on my Linux, and I forgot to share. So
no
just
worries. Thank you.
Just a quick refresh, because you probably wondered what I was talking about. So the warehouse, these are the parameters we have add onto the warehouse. So you have the post transaction, which is an account journal here, and allows us to define a default accounting journal for the revenue transactions. Here we have the default partner to be applied when the partner is not known from the post, and the analytic account that is applied on the revenues account move line. So that was for the warehouse. Then on the accounting side, we have here a new menu, post transactions, and we have the intermediate tables here. We have the mapping. The mapping allows us to define a charge code from the post side. So let's say you have a best or resort or any external post, often in the post, the revenues are tracked under charge code. It can be directly the account. In that case, you just have to set the right code for the account. And we map here the charge code of the external post to the account of Odoo. So we can manage as many charge codes as we want, and map them with the account. We have the same logic for the payment journal, but with the exception, we had here the center, because as for cash, we want to map the right journal with the right center. We might have one payment type which is called cash for several external posts, several centers. But as from Odoo accounting, we want to affect the transaction into the good journal to manage one cash journal per center, per business unit. So that is for the payment journal. We have the same function for to manage the receivable account. So we have a payment type which is mapped with an account. So we can have different type of account depending on the payment type. typically when you have a partnership between the center F and a local partner, such as an hotel in our case, then you can map and affect the transactions to a different account if the partner, the affected partner, is different. And to finish, we have the same function to map the tax with the right account and the right tax. Yeah. So these parameters allow us to manage and convert the transaction into Odoo accounting. So there we have two actions: the import of the transaction and the conversions. For today, I won't demonstrate the import because it's a basic function that allows to import CSV files from a server into Odoo. There, and we have another actions that we will see after the presentations of the intermediate tables. So the intermediate tables take this form. So we have one table for the payments, one table for the revenues, and one for the taxes. How does it work? At the end of each day, the client will make an extractions of the data from the different posts. It will group and aggregate the data to get a line per center, per transaction date, payment type, and partner. And at the end of the day, it will have three files, one for the payment, one for the revenues, and one for the taxes. So as for payment, we log the center, the transaction date, payment type. The partner reference here is not mandatory because by default, if it's not filled, we will apply a default partner of the journal, of the warehouse, sorry. And of course, we have the total amount of the payment for this payment method for the day. Then we have the same functioning for revenues. We define the center here. So the center is mapped during the import with the warehouse code. So it doesn't have to be mapped afterward in the conversions. Then we have the transaction date, the descriptions, which is actually the label, which will be the label into the account move line. And we have the charge code, which will serve to map and affect the right account of revenues. And of course, we have the total amount of revenues for this charge code, for this center and the day. And we have the same function for the tax. So the list takes this form. We define the center, which is the warehouse, the transaction date, the tax code, and the amount. So how does it work? We will just create data. So you can see here, there is a status. The conversion status, by default, when you create a new record, the status is empty. So it means that it is still to be converted by the conversion cron, the conversion job. And when it will be converted, the status is updated during the job. So here, let's see. So I select the date of today. Payment type will be cash. And say 1 in 50. I will add a second line. And here. So we have now two different line in payments. So just to be more specific, during the conversions, there are different controls that are applied. The main one is on the balance between payments and the total of revenues plus tax. So for a given center, the total of payments must be equal to the total of revenues plus tax. If it's not the case, an error will be raised and given in the job queue application, as we will see just after the test. So I have made the payment. So I will just add revenues. Don't remind. So I can add one type of charge code here. And another line. So just don't pay too much attention on the taxes amount. I will make it very simple just to demonstrate. So we have made the payment, the revenue, and we need to fill up the payment amount with taxes to have the revenues and tax equal to the payments for these two centers. So 1 in 40. So now I will just declare the tax for the days. Yeah. So now we have two lines of payments for the date of today with two different center, one type of payment. I could also just do that to show you that there are different journal use if, according to the payment type. We have the revenues here. One per center, and we have the taxes. So from there, of course, the manual actions here can be triggered by your cron. So given the recurrence and the frequency you need, here we just add the two action menu, so you can start the actions from here. So I will click to convert and see. the status was updated. So that means the accounting moves, the account moves was just created. If we go to see in the account moves, we can see that for the date of today, there were four different account moves created. If we see this one, for example, for the center two, we have here the payment account moves. So the cash versus the receivable. And we have, of course, here the revenues. One line was that was mapped with the charge code here, and the tax and the receivable. So that's where the control is made between the payment and the total of tax and revenues. Same thing for the first center, where we have an account move of payment here with the given with the default partner, because we didn't have any partner to apply on the line in the from the external post there, and we have here our payment. Same thing, we have the account move for the revenues. Yeah, we can see that the analytic account is applied by default, because it was defined in underwears. So that is the function from the for the accounting. Of course, there are control. Let's say, just to show you, if I create just one line here, we have a different amount. So let's say, so here I will say yeah, and I will voluntarily on purpose say that the tax isn't enough to fill up the balance. So we'll try to convert it and see the result. So the record is still not converted here. And if you want the details, we find here the error of the job. So of course we have the classic traceback, and it says that the conversion could not be processed because the sum of the payment is not equal to sum of revenues and taxes for the date and the center. So it's working pretty well. Our client that is using the solution runs it with 20 different centers and can produce his statement for the different centers every month. So far it's good. We haven't had any blocking issues after deploying. But of course, as we see, the solution design could be improved. So now we will just have a quick look at the inventory connection. And then I'd like us to be able to share on your same type of experience and what call did you have to implement the solution. So for the inventory,
Julian, we only have 5 minutes left, and we need to also cover your questions. So just a heads up.
I will just be quick then. As for the inventory, the exact same thing, unless we don't have to map, because as you can see here, the data is very simple. We have one the warehouse which is directly defined during the import. Then we map the product based on the its reference. We have two different type of move, in and out, for the return and the shipping, a transaction date, and a folio with, which is the folio of the external post. When the transaction is converted into a stock moves, of course we have the stock move in the inventory. And of course, if the valorization is automated of the inventory value, then the account move is posted when the account move, the stock move is validated. So it's basically the same functioning, but in a simpler versions. So I think we have done for the demonstration, Rodrigo.
Okay, perfect. Thank you, Julian, for your talk. Really interesting. We have a couple of questions here. I will try to go really quick onto that. First question is from Babesh. He's asking, what is the reason to add new configurations fields in the warehouse? Why not in journals?
Why not in account journals?
Mm-hmm.
Because we have we might have more warehouse for a single journal. Let's say for the cash, for the Visa, sorry, for a payment method like Visa or MasterCard, we will have in this case only one journal, which is Visa, and several center using this payment journal. So we make the choice to implement the parameters directly on the warehouse. I don't know if I'm clear, but
Yeah. There's another question. Who will be responsible for validating intermediate table records?
It's generally in our case, it's the company controller. Which made the control between the source data and the external post reporting system.
Okay, there's two more questions, and I will try to be quick. Is there any case where when import trigger fails or just fetch cover to auto flag equal phase to convert into true?
Yes, there might be error during the import. For example, we expect the warehouse code to be unique in the database, and if we have two warehouses with the same code, then during the import, the job will trigger an error. Yes.
Okay. And also, Felix was asking if you can give a brief summary of the importance of this model.
Of the, sorry?
Importance of this model, in your opinion.
Of the importance of this module, sorry, I don't think I see the question.
Yeah, it's an open, a very open question. I guess maybe he's asking about what do you think this was a key part in the project, or any final thought about it? Yeah.
Actually, yes, it was a key part in the project. The client had two different posts which had very extensive functions and features. To reproduce them in Odoo would be not profitable for the client, clearly. At first, the client was all in for having the detailed transactions into Odoo. But when we analyzed the thing, we quickly understand that it wouldn't be easily feasible. So we opt for that type of integrations.
Great.
But yes, it was a key part in this project.
Okay, that's perfect. Well, thank you, Julian. Thank you for the talk. Thank you for answering the questions, and thanks everybody for attending.